It's lovely to see you. I know it's been a little while since I've hosted any of my classes, but I'm going to start hosting again. I hope you'll be pleased to know. And I thought, as well as my usual vinyasa flow style classes, I'm going to post a series of restorative classes, because there's so many awful things going on in our world at the moment. You know, we just sometimes need to ground ourselves and remove ourselves from the outside world and just really come and find some inner peace. And we can obviously do that, hopefully, through our yoga practice and meditation. And restorative poses are really good for feeling supported, feeling calm, enabling yourself to come inwards and just find that inner connection again. So with restorative classes though, we do need quite a few props. You know, you can find alternatives, but I do find that a proper bolster is really worth an investment, because even if you're not using it for yoga, you can use it, you can lie on it while you're watching TV, or you can, you know, if you're working at home, you could maybe sit on that or have it propped up against your back. They're just really useful, so, you know, I would recommend investing in one. We also need a couple of blocks. If you haven't got blocks, maybe some nice thick hard-backed books, or obviously blocks are slightly more comfortable because they're a little bit softer. And we also need a rolled up towel or blanket. And obviously a yoga mat. Make sure you feel warm. Make sure you've got a nice quiet place. And we'll get started. So we're starting off with something called surfer's pose, which sounds quite fun. So we need to take the bolster lengthways along the mat. We need to have one block at the front, and we need to take the rolled up towel or blanket horizontally towards the back of the mat. And you might just need to, you know, adjust yourselves a couple of times until you feel completely comfortable. But we're going to lie face down, hence surfer's pose, like we were lying down on the surfboard, paddling out to sea. And I like to think of it, if you're a lady, of lying down, and it comes, the top of the bolster comes to about the bra line. And then I just need to perhaps bring this blanket a little bit closer so the tops of my feet can rest on the blanket. Actually, no, sorry. Let's take it back again. There we are. That's better. Okay, so just as I say, make sure you adjust yourself so you feel comfortable, and then you rest your forearms down, like a bit like Sphinx pose, and just bring the forehead to the block. And as I say, just make sure you do get yourself in the right position, because we're going to stay here for 4 or 5 minutes. Just completely relaxing into the pose. It should feel like there's no effort, really. Restorative poses are meant to be completely supported by all of the props that we use. They help support your body weight. And this particular class is going to enable you to open your chest, your shoulders, your back, release of the lower back in a supported way without effort. So as we start to settle in here, just
just position your forehead so you feel the skin releasing downwards. And as we are in this particular prone position with the eyes closed, you can really feel the optic nerve switch off. And it might make you realize how much energy it takes to keep using the optic nerve. So just appreciate this feeling of being supported and just letting go. And start to feel everything release downwards. Let the tongue gently relax into the roof of the mouth. I particularly like this pose for feeling the eye muscles relaxing in the back of the sockets. Feel the shoulders releasing down as gravity pushes down. Feel the upper back and the chest widening. And you might just want to fidget a little bit as you just feel the bolster taking the weight of the length of the front of the body. And you might just want to move side to side with the pelvis. It might just feel nice to release the lower back. It's not really a position in we're very often. You know, even if we lie on our fronts when we go to bed at night, we are not supported in this way by the bolster, and it is just a really nice way to release. And if you're not used to restorative poses or meditation, you know, if you start to feel even a little bit panicky because we're just coming into these resting restorative positions, just have a strategy so that if your mind starts to wander, you start to get thoughts coming in, you get a bit panicky or anxious, have a tool ready, if you like, to help you move past that. So you could start thinking about a close friend that's dear to you, to your partner, maybe just visualizing their face and what they mean to you. Or it could be a visualization of one of your favorite locations, somewhere peaceful, somewhere in nature, perhaps with birds singing. You can smell the trees. Maybe it's pine trees, that perfume smell of pine needles. Maybe the sea is gently moving, waving in the background to the ebb and flow of the tide. Or you might be visualizing a forest surrounded by the calming nature and canopies of trees. But just make sure that in this visualization, if it's a person or a place, it's someone or somewhere that makes you feel safe, calm, joyous, happy, supportive. So just taking another few moments here. Maybe take a couple of deeper breaths as you're starting to relax into this restorative session. Okay, and then just start to think about opening the eyes, lifting the head, gently push into the forearms, move the hands back closer towards the chest, and lift up, come onto the knees. Good, and just sit back for a moment, maybe just move the blanket. And just let that first pose settle for a moment. Maybe you feel some vibration in the head and the ears. Energy vibration. Essentially the sound of Om. Okay, so the next pose we're going to do is a supported, wide-legged supported child's pose. So again, we need the bolster and a couple of blocks. So we keep the bolster lengthways. Grab the two blocks. So we're going to be sitting wide-legged, the toes touching, with the bolster between the legs. And then we take the first block, which I like to call the medium way, and we just place it in the under the centre of the bolster. And then the other block, the tallest way, at the top of the bolster. So you can see it's at a nice angle, ready for you to lie down on. And this time when we lie down, we're going to turn our face to the side. So what we'll do is we'll turn our face to the side for half the time, and then I will tell you when it's time to lift up, and then we'll gently just transfer and lie back down with the face the other way. And also when we lie forward, as you'll see, just make sure it is in the right position. You might just need to scoot back a bit so you can rest the face on the block. And then it's quite comforting maybe to clasp or link the forearms around the middle block. So you feel like you're hugging someone close to you. If that feels a bit strange, you can just gently rest the forearms on the floor. And so we'll just be here for a couple of minutes on this side, and then we'll change our face to the other side. Again, so there's no effort. This is a nice pose, particularly for releasing the real lower back, the sacral area. Many of us have tightness in that area, through sitting too often, maybe always leaning forward slightly to look at our iPhones or iPads, and then also tension, which we get in the neck and the shoulders, can then radiate down the spine. So it's just a really nice way, supported way to
Gently release and lengthen the back. And again, that visualization that you had in the first pose, let that flood back in. Let other thoughts float away. And just notice how that your favourite image or your favourite person, just notice how that makes you feel in your physical body. And then bring that feeling internally to your inner centre. So you feel loved and supported. Okay, and then just lift up. Lengthen the spine again, and then we're just going to release to the other side. Just notice how this position allows you to feel as if the breath is really moving into the back of the lungs and widening the upper back. And then I'll just be quiet for a minute or so as you just really embrace this feeling, feel comforted and supported. Take a breath, gently lift up, and again take a moment just to sit up with the spine straight and let the effects of that posture flood throughout the body. So the next pose we are going to do is a lovely supported Sphinx pose, with the option at the end to do a supported bow pose with really no effort. So it's just a really nice way to open the heart, the upper back and the chest. So first of all, we need the bolster, keeping it widthways, and we need the blocks, both blocks, medium way towards the top of the mat. And we want to lie down so that when we lie down, the bolster is roughly at the bottom edge of the ribs. And you might just need to play around till you feel comfortable. The pelvis should feel supported. It's going to move forward slightly. And then you rest your hand, your forearms on the blocks. And if that feels too high for you, too much, you can just bring the forearms to the floor. And if it's still too much and you just really don't want any real chest opening particularly, you can just fold the forearms
and bring the head down.
But if you can, it's just a really nice way to feel a chest and upper back opening without really too much effort. So just feeling the pelvis releasing. Gently feel the forearms releasing into the blocks. And just notice how you can, in this position, the lower back can lengthen without too much effort. And the chest is lifted. And so obviously when we normally do Sphinx pose or upward facing dog or cobra, we have to use our muscular strength to lengthen the lower back and to raise the chest and the upper back. And you know, if you have got any issues going on with the lower back, sometimes you can feel some compression in the lower back, which we obviously don't want. And this supported variation is just a nice way to make sure that doesn't happen. To really feel what it feels like to have a nice open heart and chest. Maybe you want to close your eyes and just visualize the heart center, the Anahata chakra. Visualize the earth energy, unmanifested energy, radiating in through the heart. And then radiating along the length of the spine, up to the crown of the head. Okay, and then you can stay here or you can maybe just take the blocks away, or for the last minute, if you wanted a little bit of a bigger chest opening in a supported way through supported bow pose, Dhanurasana, you can start to pick the feet up, reach the hands back for the ankles, and really without any effort, just feel the shoulders opening, keep the knees down. If that doesn't feel right to you, just immediately release it. But if it feels okay to you, just enjoy this way of coming into bow pose, Dhanurasana, without too much effort. Lifting and radiating the chest open. Good, okay. you're in that variation, we can all release now and make a pillow with the forearms.
Just bring the forehead down just for a few moments. There's a little counter pose. Breathing deeply. Just feel the lower back lengthening. Feel gravity lengthening out the spine. And the bolster taking the weight of the pelvis.
Good, and then gently release, bring the hands down and sit back onto the knees. Okay, how are you all doing? Hope you're enjoying it so far. So now we're going to come into a couple of forward folds. So the first one is Upavista Konasana, Parsva Upavista Konasana. So it just means half side angle pose. So, you know, if you've got open hips, you don't need to come to your widest position, just bring the legs out to a fairly relaxed angle. We don't need to think about too much effort here. And we're taking the bolster the length way along the, we'll start off with the left leg. And maybe if you've got the blanket handy, you might just want to place the blanket there just to rest the forehead down. But we take an inhale and we lengthen and we just start to turn the body towards the left leg. Normally we would be trying to keep the right hip on the floor. You know, if it feels more comfortable and easeful to lift it slightly so you can really turn the body to the left, that's fine. And then exhale and just start to release the body to the bolster. And just relax. Just position the towel or the blanket maybe you just want to have the hands clasped around the top of the bolster. Again, just relax into this. So, making sure you feel comfortable, as I say, there's no effort. If you've got tighter hamstrings, make sure that you do feel comfortable. Keep a micro bend in the knees and just bring the legs to a slightly smaller angle so they're not so wide. You don't want to feel any strain in the lower back in this position. It's always about being supported. And the other option is, once you're down, if it's feeling a little bit uncomfortable still, you can always place a block under the top of the bolster again to give it a bit more height so you're not coming down so quite so far down. So it's your practice, so just do what feels comfortable for you to feel supported and comfortable. And you might just notice the shoulders really release. I just felt mine release.
again, let the breath come naturally. If you feel like you want to take some deeper breaths into the back of the lungs, just do what feels right for you and keep coming back to that lovely visualization that we had at the beginning, that the person or that image that instills feelings of warmth and love and joy and happiness and safety. Okay, and then just slowly start to lift up. And we'll just move over to the other side. So take the block to the inner seam of the right leg. Again, you might want to angle the left hip slightly, might even lift up slightly, so you can really rotate the body to the right. And exhale and just gently fold over. Remembering that these are meant to be fairly effortless poses. So if you're not used to restorative poses, it can be difficult to just to let go and to let go of a normal practice where we are putting in obviously a lot of effort. Here, this is just about being supported, making the body feel good, letting go. So just make sure you've got the props correctly to allow you to just relax and feel comfortable.
Good. And so you might have guessed that now we're going to come into full Upa Vista Konasana, folding forward, obviously in a supported way. So some of you might feel fine to just fold forward just with the bolster and the towel or the blanket. If that again feels too much, you've got the option of placing a block, the medium way, probably. Can even be the tall way if you're feeling just like you just really want to just have a very small angle coming forward. So just work and just see what feels right to you. I think in fact I'll keep the block here on the medium way, it does feel quite nice. And then that just allows me to rest the forearms on the floor, clasp the hands around the block gently, and just feel really supported. Particularly if you've got any lower back issues, you know, the higher the angle, the higher the block is, it's going to create the bolster at a higher angle so you don't have to fold so far forward. And that just can feel a bit more comfortable for the back. And hopefully, once you start to practice some more restorative sequences, you'll really be able to feel their benefit to your inner self, to your mental state, and hopefully it can allow you to just for a while at least shut yourself off into a little bubble, forgetting everything that's going on in the external world, and just coming to your inner place of happiness, of calmness, remembering that we are all part of nature. And just coming back to that stillness and happiness. And then hopefully by nurturing yourself in this way, you'll then feel stronger and more able to conduct yourself in the external world as inevitably we have to, and to help and support your family and friends. Just taking another moment or so here in stillness. Start to lift up. Once you're upright, just take a moment, again noticing if you can really feel the energy vibrations in the spaces in your head, between your third eye, your Ajna chakra, between your inner ears, pulsating down to your heart center. Okay, so we're going to move into final supported shavasana now. So for that we will need just the bolster. And if you want to have a little bit of a tiny opening for your shoulders and upper chest, the rolled up towel or mat, blanket again. And I have actually got an iPad here as well. If you've got one of those, an eye blanket, a lavender one, it feels really nice for your eyes. So we need to, when we lie down, make sure the blanket or the towel comes to the tips of the shoulder blades, and the bolster is going to be widthways. I'm going to be resting under our knees. Again, you might need to just keep adjusting for a couple of times till you feel comfortable. And if once you lie down that feels too much with the blanket there, you can just forget that and just lie down without it. And I'm actually going to use my eye pillow here as well. Just having a little bit of pressure, weight on the eyes just encourages them to relax back into the eye sockets, the muscles around the eyes relax. And the legs be about hip distance apart. And first of all, if you are lying on the towel or the blanket, bring your arms into this cactus shape with the fingers pointing upwards. And just so you can really feel like you're releasing and opening the shoulder girdle, just get it in the right position. And then you can flop the forearms out to the side. If that doesn't feel comfortable, you can release the arms down slightly. But if you have got that towel or the blanket there, it does feel quite nice keeping the arms in this sort of cactus arm variation. And again, it's just a very subtle, supported way to broaden the chest and the upper back while you're in your final relaxation. So just completely relaxed, feeling supported. There's no effort. And again, if the mind starts to get a bit jittery, you get unwanted thoughts coming in, just acknowledge that, but just let the thoughts float away and be replaced with that lovely image, and transport yourself to a happy place, whether it's with one of your loved ones or one of your dear friends, or you're just on your own in a beautiful location that's dear to you. Somewhere, preferably in nature. And just notice how that's making you feel, that positive energy flooding through the body. also just starting to bring your awareness back . Make you take a nice deep breath in. Sigh it out. Maybe to start to flex and point the feet slowly, moving the body. I'll take my iPad off. And then just bend the legs, put the feet on the bolster and just gently push it away so that you can roll onto your right side. And then gently come up to a seated position. And hopefully you are feeling calm and renewed and happy. So I hope you enjoyed that beautiful yogis. I'll be posting some more restorative classes on my YouTube channel, as well as some more vinyasa flow style classes. So have a wonderful rest of your day or evening, and I hope to see you next time. Namaste.